What's up, guys? I'm Shane, and this is Spare Change. Here on the channel, we discuss all things audio and video, like new movies and new AV equipment. So if it's your first time here, consider tapping that subscribe button for new weekly videos. This is just a quick shout out to all of our Patreon subscribers who told us that this movie is available in 4K and in Atmos for streaming. So thanks for that, and thanks for supporting the channel on Patreon. Today for review, we've got 2013's Elysium on 4K digital streaming. You can catch this on either Vudu or on iTunes, and as far as I know, it's not on physical media just yet. Now, I won't be reviewing the movie itself, I'm just going to share with you some of my thoughts on the video and the audio quality. Now let's just go over a few tech specs. The movie was shot in 3.3K, it's got a 4K DI, it's rated R, runtime is 109 minutes, aspect ratio is 235:1, which means it'll have black letterbox bars. Now despite what you might think of the movie itself, it is a great looking movie. If you like that clean, digitally shot look, then I'm sure you'll like this one a lot. If you've got a solid internet connection, you'll find that this movie falls in the 4K crispy territory. The close-up shots look fantastic. Matt Damon's hair follicles and fake tattoos are rendered just about perfectly. You'll find tons of detail on props like the mech suit, on all the weaponry, and textures throughout all the sets are intricately detailed as well. As for HDR in Dolby Vision, this is one of those bright transfers from start to finish. The color palette ranges from very warm sepia tones when in Los Angeles and takes on a more natural look and somewhat cooler look when they get on Elysium. Blues and greens are richly saturated, which gives Elysium a nice inviting appearance, while in LA, everything is hot and grungy feeling. Specular highlights pop off the screen from the bright Los Angeles skyline to sparkling reflective surfaces, and those electric gunshots and explosions will have you squinting for sure. Black levels added great contrast to the image, elevating depth, although there are times I did see some blotchiness in the darker scenes. But keep in mind, I'm sure this is due to it being a digital stream.
Wait, what? No, I can explain what happened.
Audio is in Dolby Atmos, and I thought it had some decent overhead surround activity. Anytime there's an aircraft, you'll usually hear them fly above in the high channels. The drones have some good movement when they fly from lower surrounds up top, and during the many shootouts, you'll hear things ping through different speakers, supplying you with some good surround immersion. As for base response, I didn't think it was anything too crazy, but the ships exploding out in space or that crash landing on Elysium digs pretty low. The shootouts have some pretty decent punch, which will give your speakers a healthy workout. I found soundstage was sufficiently wide, but I'm sure a less compressed audio stream would have sounded a lot bigger. Dialogue was perfectly audible without any issues, so hearing people talk was no problem. So for audio, I'm gonna go with an 8.7. I thought this was a good Atmos mix with properly placed sound effects, which matched everything that was happening on screen. Soundstage was decent, but like I mentioned, I think this could sound even cleaner if this ever gets a physical release. For video, I'm gonna go with a 9.2. This is a crisp 4K transfer with tons of details in every shot. Dolby Vision adds some excellent pop and some great colors. Unfortunately, being a digital stream, there are times where fast motion will make the picture go a bit soft, and shadow detail wasn't always solid. This, of course, is network dependent, so your viewing experience could be different than mine. So the question is, should you pick this up on digital or wait for the physical disc? I don't think there's a date set for the physical version, but the digital is only a couple bucks. So if you like sci-fi movies that look and sound great, then you might want to give this one a watch. I'll leave links for Elysium down below in the video's description if you do want to pick it up. So what are your thoughts on the Elysium 4K transfer? Leave us a comment and let us know. As always, guys, thanks for watching. If you want, you can follow us on social media, and if you want to support the channel and get exclusive content or great discounts on audio and video gear, then stop by our Patreon page. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you guys again in the next video.